I'm not sure if it's escaped you or not, but I'm not a woman, nor a feminist, or an activist. So you're probably wondering, why am I up here? What's this guy doing? Am I even qualified to speak about the issue of gender inequality? And so I thought to myself, this is going to be great. What could go wrong? After an amazing trip in Scotland, we are now heading to Dublin, Ireland, my first time ever. I was invited to speak at Y Design during IDI's Gender Balance Initiative for the Irish design sector. Here's some things that I've observed as an instructor teaching design. A lot of my students, more than half of them, are female. But the interesting thing is once we enter into the workplace, especially in the motion design community, there are fewer than half of them that are working inside the field, and even fewer in management or leadership roles.
My name is Billie Jean, and I'm originally from Dublin, but I live in Wexford. I am currently a visual communication student in the Gorey School of Art. I've always been interested in design since I was like really small. I was kind of obsessed getting through college in Ireland, kind of not the same level as the States. It's quite hard though still. And then after that, it's just kind of establishing myself with a strong enough portfolio to get work. I'm really excited to see like a really balanced, informative discussion from the whole panel between Chris and Annie and Aoife. I think it's good variety of perspective, so I think we'll get a lot out of the night just from the different points of view.
So I was truly excited when Billie Jean said, would you like to come to Ireland? And we're gonna connect you to Kim. So of course, I said yes, and that's why I'm here today. So I do what I normally do, which is I reach out to this wonderful community online, and I throw this tweet up. And I asked, why aren't there more women in design? What I didn't realize was I was stepping into a political and an emotional landmine. This is the second part to the tweet. It said, what's the problem, and how can we address this? And what ensued was Twitterverse exploded on my face, and there was tremendous backlash. I should have said, I need help, I've been invited, I don't know what I'm doing, and throw myself on the sword, please help me. Now I went in with the best of intentions and an open heart, but the response was not what I had expected. Women would say, don't put the burden of learning on us, we've had enough stuff to deal with. You, as a man, need to figure it out yourself. And that's saying it nicely, okay? The other thing that really hurt me on an emotional level was I've always considered myself an outsider, a person who has worked really hard to fit into communities, never finding my place, and then now I'm being attacked, and it did not feel good. I thought I was one of the good guys. I've always felt like I've identified more with women than with men. I hired women. I paid women more than their male counterparts. Don't tell them that. Sorry. These are the two scrubs I could bring with me, you guys. All right. And I hired women to hold the highest positions of power in our company. At one point, we were all women except for me. So I started thinking, this wasn't right for me. I tried to quit. And this was even my idea. Somebody direct messaged me, you should quit. You don't deserve to be there. You are taking the place as someone more deserving than you. Oh, you wrote it? Oh, okay, it's like, stop.
I thought to myself that of all the motion design companies that I know of, very few are owned by women. So something is going on here. And I think it's important to have this dialogue out in the open to be honest and authentic about what we see, what our observations are, and what we can do together to create more balance and equity in the workplace.
As you guys know, if you've had any therapy work, as I have, the things you react to today are kind of things that you're still trying to deal with from your past. This is not a story I share very often, but it gave me a flashback to my childhood. That's my mom and my dad. I'm the girl in the yellow dress, okay? And we're first generation immigrants. We fled Vietnam in 1975 to escape communism. So we came to the United States when I was 3 years old. And we left everything. And that kind of change was hard on a kid like me. Unathletic, shy, introverted. It was really hard to make friends. I desperately, like every young person, you just want to belong and to be accepted. Because as you can see, I'm not a big guy. not masculine, didn't like sports. In some neighborhoods, I was not brown enough, and for some, I wasn't white enough. And that meant I was isolated, targeted, and picked on by bullies and bigots who would yell racial slurs at me. I was spit on by complete strangers, and I got into lots of fights. Kids of all shapes and sizes would try to punch me and take me out. Now, I'm not telling you I'm brave or courageous or strong or I had a chip to prove. I just was in survival mode. And unfortunately, all that external pressure really started to make me lose myself. But here I am looking to quit. And I was thinking, how ironic. I'm on the internet telling everybody, face your fears, overcome doubt. And here it is, I was looking for the exit door. And in my darkest moment, it was the generosity of strangers, women, who reached out to lend a helping hand. And they helped me to find my way back. They would chat with me for hours during that very long weekend. They would encourage me to tell my story, to tell my truth, and show up as myself. That's what I'm doing here. And one woman in particular, Diane Gibbs, reminded me of all the good that I was doing, and I needed to be here today to tell you the story.
If I'm being honest, I was really scared because the first time I dipped my toes into the gender inequality topic, I got my head bit off online. Reality did not measure up to my fears because people there, the audience in attendance, were really warm, welcoming, friendly. I just found it extremely open and accepting. So most of my fears were unwarranted. And this is an example of where something that happens online isn't indicative of how it really works in real life. Thank you.